Welcome to the class of high voltage engineering. So I have started the discussion on generation of high voltage. So in the first part, we have seen that how the high voltage DC is being generated in high voltage laboratories for the purpose of testing the insulations and the high voltage equipments to obtain its quality on the basis of its DC performance characteristic. So in that lesson, we have seen the half wave and full wave rectifier circuits. We have discussed voltage doubler circuits. Then we have discussed voltage multiplier circuit and the electrostatic generators. Today, our agenda is to discuss the generation of high voltage AC. So let us consider the first part of our discussion on generation of high voltage AC. Normally, the insulations in high voltage testing laboratories evaluated under the application of high voltage AC at power frequency as well as the high voltage AC at high frequency. So considering these two parts, let us start our discussion with generation of high voltage AC at power frequency. So power frequency AC high voltages are basically produced by using a single unit testing transformer or by connecting the testing transformers in series or by using the resonant transformer. So let us take the first case, the generation of high voltage AC at power frequency using testing transformers. So power frequency single phase transformer is a most common method to produce the high voltage AC. So as the name is given as a transformer, it means that we are producing the high voltage AC at power frequency by stepping up the voltage level from its low value to the high value. So these testing transformers are nothing but they are the step up transformer, but they always in the form of single phase. So let me show you how it looks like. Here I have shown you, if you can see this figure, it will represent a testing transformer. So from this figure or from this photograph, you can see that this is a single phase unit. Okay, this is a step up transformer which is in single phase. They may also be used for the high frequencies with rated voltage or for low frequencies if the voltages are reduced according to the frequency to avoid the saturation of the core. So depending upon the frequency requirement, the material used to prepare the core of this testing transformer also get differs, because we need to deal with the saturation of the core. And as you know that if the core gets saturated due to the variation in frequency, then it may inject the harmonics. Okay, so this presence of the harmonic due to the saturation of the core, okay, due to the saturation of the core may hurdle you to evaluate the performance of the high voltage equipment under the application of high voltage AC. The another point is the testing transformer. So as the name is specifically given as testing, it means that whatever the voltage level that we are going to get at its secondary terminal, we are using those voltages only for testing purpose. So these transformers are not designed to transmit or distribute the power. Okay, these transformers are specifically designed for producing or stepping up the voltages required to test the high voltage equipments and insulations at high voltage laboratories. So if you are considering the design of these testing transformers, then you may find some kind of the differences compared with the design of the power transformers and the distribution transformer. So if we are considering its thermal rating, the KV output and its fundamental design of the core and winding, a little bit of difference you can observe. Okay, there is not a big kind of the difference you can observe in its design. Okay, there is a little bit of difference you can observe between the design of the testing transformers and the design of the power transformers and distribution transformers. And these testing transformers, okay, they are always single phase, whereas the power transformers, distribution transformers are in three phase as well. So let me see that what sort of the differences we can observe between this testing transformer and our conventional transformer. So number one point that we can observe in its design is the flux density. Okay, the flux density of the core that you can have in testing transformer is somewhat smaller as compared to the flux density required in conventional transformer. Now why this flux density needs to be smaller? Just to avoid unnecessarily high magnetizing current. Okay, so if the magnetizing currents are high, then they may produce the higher amount of harmonics. Okay, so it may create the improper functioning of the testing transformers, and also it hurdles us to get the proper information regarding the behavior of the testing object. A very compact and well insulated high voltage winding for the rated voltage. Okay, here in the photograph you might have seen that the design is very very compact, and of course they are the high voltage transformers, so they should be well insulated. Okay, their winding must be well insulated, because as the voltage rating goes high, the insulations of the winding must be capable enough to withstand the large electrostatic forces. Okay, so the single phase testing unit may be compared with the construction of the potential transformer that we are used for the measurement of voltage and the power in power transmission system. So you can compare its design with this power transformer, electromagnetic PTs. Okay, they are quite similar in design. So let me show you, there are the two types of testing transformers. Okay, in figure B, it represents the tank type construction. So in the photograph, I have shown the testing transformer which has a tank type construction. Second is the insulated enclosure type construction. Okay, so you can see the differences between the tank type construction and the insulated enclosure type construction. So here number one, okay, the number one in both of the cases, it will represent the iron core. The point number two, let me highlight it. This point number one represents the iron core, okay, of the testing transformers. This point number 2 represents the low voltage winding or the exciting winding. This 3 represents the high voltage winding. 4 represents the field grading shield. Okay, this field grading shield is generally provided to get the uniform distribution of the electric field stress across the each turns of the windings, so that it can provide the better protection towards the inter-turn insulation. The fifth number, okay, here you can see this is the fifth number and this is the fifth number in figures B and C, which represents the grounded metallic tank, okay, and the base. Sixth number represents the high voltage bushing. Okay, here in case of the tank type construction, you need a bushing to get the connection with the high voltage winding, whereas as you can see in the enclosure type, okay, the bushing is not present. Then this seven number, okay, seven number represents insulating shell or the tank, okay, insulating shell or the container inside which you find the core and the winding structures. Eight number represents the high voltage electrode. So you can see the size of the high voltage electrodes in the insulated enclosure type construction and even in the tank type construction, okay, both are different. So in case of the tank type, as you can see that the core and windings are enclosed into the metallic container and the surface of which is a natural cooled surface. So here it provides the natural cooling to the current carrying parts. So with high working voltages, the cost of the bushing, as you can see that the bushing is mandatory to get the connection from the high voltage winding which is enclosed into the metallic container. Okay, so as the voltage level increases, you need the larger size of the bushing just to avoid the lower clearance between the high voltage electrode and the earth metallic tank or the grounded metallic tank. Okay, so ultimately as we are increasing the voltage level, the size of the bushing is also needs to be longer enough. Okay, so ultimately it will add in the cost. So for the very high working voltages, the better option is to go with this insulated enclosure type construction. In insulated enclosure type, the core and windings, as you can see, they are surrounded by the insulating cylinder. So transformers of this kind contains the large quantity of the oil, so they are the oil filled type of the transformers. Okay, so generally they use a large quantity of oil so that they have the higher value of thermal time constant. So now as this transformer has a larger value of the thermal time constant, so the opposite effect of this is the heat dissipation through this insulated enclosure is quite small. Okay, so that is the that could be the danger towards the performance of this insulated enclosure type of construction compared with this tank type of construction. So because of this issue with this insulated enclosure type, normally the high voltage laboratories prefer to use the tank type of construction to produce the higher testing voltages. The another thing is, as you can see that there is no bushing, okay, so it can allow the larger radius of the high voltage electrode. So these are the two drawbacks normally associated with this insulated enclosure type of construction over the tank type of construction. So considering the advantages of the tank type, morally the tank type construction feature is used in the high voltage laboratories for the generation of high voltage AC at power frequency for testing purpose. So they are available into the single unit, but if we are considering the larger rating of the voltages, okay, during the time of the testing, then obviously it needs the very big size of the transformers. Okay, you know that if we are suppose increasing the voltage level, it means that ideally it needs more amount of insulation. Okay, the size of the transformer is also increasing. So ultimately, as we increasing the voltage level, the cost of the equipment will also becomes large. Okay, so not only it affects to the cost of the design parameters, but it also affects the cost to the transportation as well. Then the cost of the space requirement and everything. Okay, so to produce the very large magnitude of the potentials, then the cascade connection of the transformers are more preferable to use. So this testing transformers of a single unit can be used up to the limited voltage level, let us say up to 300 kV or something. But where the voltage rating requirement is somewhat more than 300 kV, then the cascading connection of the transformers, cascading connections of the testing transformers are more preferable. So the cascading connections can also give us the high voltage AC at power frequency. So here you can see I have shown you the photographs where the three testing transformers of a single phase are connected in series, where this blue transformer which is placed onto the ground is a stage number one, then the second transformer is the stage two transformer, and third is stage three transformer. Okay, so if suppose I want to draw its circuit arrangement, then it will looks like this. Okay, so this will represents your ground structure. This is the stage number one transformer, which you can see over here. It is represented as blue. Okay, here there is a primary. So A dash represents the primary winding. The input voltage varies from 230 volt to 1 kilovolt. Okay, this is the secondary winding. This part represents the secondary winding of the first stage transformer. So now here you can see that the secondary of this high voltage testing transformer is divided into the three parts. Number one part, this BD portion. This BD portion is known as a metering winding. The purpose of this metering winding is to measure the generated secondary voltage. This B dash C, okay, this B dash C dash. This B dash C dash represents the excitation winding. Okay, the role of this excitation winding is to provide input to the primary of the second state transformer. So here you can see that B dash C dash of excitation winding of first stage secondary is connected with primary of second state transformer AA dash. Okay, so here if suppose I am giving the input voltage of, let us say, 1 kilovolt, then I need to select the number of turns from the secondary of first state transformer to get 1 kV output. And that winding, that number of turns are connected to the primary of the second state transformer. Okay, so here again I am getting 1 kV. So when you want to connect the two transformers in series, both the transformers must be identical in nature. Okay, that is the condition you need to follow. Okay, so now as both the transformers have the same operating characteristics and same rating and same specifications, this B dash C dash will give me 1 kV of output to energize the primary of the second state transformer with 1 kV. Whereas this C dash 2D will represents the high voltage winding. So let us assume that this transformer, the first state transformer, has a specification of 1 kV to 50 kV. 1 kV to 50 kV. Suppose this is the rating. So at the secondary terminal, I am getting 50 kV of output. From excitation winding, I am getting 1 kV. Okay, here I am getting 1 kV. So now this secondary winding also produces 50 kV. Now, as you can see over here, the secondary terminal of the stage 2 transformer is connected with the tank of the transformer. Okay, the tank of the transformer 1 is grounded. Okay, the tank of the transformer 1 is grounded. So here I am getting single phase supply, which is with respect to the ground. Now, as the secondary winding of the stage 2 transformer is connected to this tank, and here you can see that This winding comes in series with the first stage secondary winding. So now the total voltage which I am getting across this terminal, okay, with respect to the ground. So in the first case, here I am getting 50 kV. Okay, the output voltage with respect to the ground of the first stage transformer is 50 kV. Okay, this connection represents the secondary connection. Okay, so now here there is the second stage transformer and its secondary winding is connected in series with the secondary of the first stage. So the total voltage which is available at output terminal of second stage transformer is 50 plus 50. 50 kV plus 50 kV, that will give me 100 kV AC. Okay, so that is the 100 kV AC with respect to the ground. Again, if further I am adding the one more stage, then at this terminal, okay, at this terminal I am getting 3V2, it means 150 kV. Okay, because the secondary windings are connected in series, so 50 plus 50 plus 50, that is 150 kV I am getting at the secondary terminal of the third stage of transformer, which is with respect to the ground. One more thing that you can observe over here is that the first stage transformer is put up into the ground, whereas the higher number of stages are normally placed above the ground. So this will represent the insulating support. This will representing the insulating supports. Now, why these supports are required? Why these supports are required? Here in the photograph, you can also see that the solid dielectric structures are provided. Okay, the height of this insulating support is equal to the height of the tank of the transformer. Okay, so here you can see in third stage also the height is double than the previous one. Okay, so why it is required? It is required to provide the necessary clearance between the high voltage terminal, between the high voltage terminal and the ground, to keep the charges with a constant value. Otherwise, what happens if suppose I am putting all these transformers directly onto the ground level, then at the output side I cannot get the expected value. So to hold up that charge or to provide the minimum clearance, normally the higher stages of the transformers are put up above the ground level, and to provide that consideration, normally the insulating supports are used. You cannot prefer to use the metallic supports because the tank of the transformer is metallic and it is grounded. Okay, so during the charging phase of this transformer, the tank may get excited, and as a result the charges may be delivered to the ground if you are using the supports made up of a metallic material. Okay, so to avoid that loss of charge phenomena, you need to provide the insulating supports. So normally in cascading connections, the three stages are more preferable, because if we are adding these stages more and more, then ultimately it will causes the unwanted loading effect to the premier stages. So here now you can see, okay, delay 1 kV is supplied to the primary of the first stage transformer and the rating is 1 kV to 100 kV. Okay, so here 100 kV. So to obtain 1 kV, we have selected the number of turns. So the potential difference is now 100 kV minus 99 kV. So we are getting over here 1 kV. So here now you can observe there is a transposition of the terminal. Okay, reversal of the phase terminals. So why this reversing is required? Because to obtain the difference, otherwise it will add the voltage, and once it will add the voltage, if you are suppose connecting this 100 kV to this and 99 kV means this terminal to this, then there is no difference. Okay, so now as there is no difference, then what it cause? It will causes the bouncing of the charge. Okay, so your internal insulation gets perfectly ionized, and because and that ionization you can also feel when you place the grounding electrode close to this metallic tank. Okay, so if suppose I am making such type of the connection, then output voltage will obviously remain zero because the charges are gathered over the tank surface. Okay, so there is a loss of charge phenomena. So to obtain that, to eliminate that component, we need to create the potential difference, and that difference can be created by reversing the connection at the secondary side. So that 100 minus 99, you will get 1 kV as the input to the primary of the second state transformer. This blue one indicates the insulating supports. Okay, so now as all the secondaries are connected in series, so at the output terminal you will get 300 kilovolt. But as I said, the drawback of this cascading connection is, you can see over here, suppose this is the loading of the transformer state number 3, because I am connecting load at the secondary of the third state transformer. So let us assume that the loading that could occur or that could be faced by secondary of the state number 3 transformer is supposed to be okay. So whatever the loading has been observed by this secondary is also observed by the primary of this transformer. Okay, so the primary of the third state transformer is also gets loaded by this P factor. Now this primary of third state transformer is connected to the excitation winding of the second state second state transformer. So excitation winding of the second state transformer is also loaded by P, and secondary of the third state transformer is connected in series with the secondary terminal of the second state transformer, so it is also gets loaded by P. So now the overall loading that could observe by the secondary of the state 2 transformer is P plus P, that is 2P. So it will load the primary of second state transformer by 2P. It will further load the excitation winding of first state transformer by 2P factor, and the secondary of second stage is connected in series with the secondary of the first stage, which is loaded by P. So overall loading that could be observed by the primary of the first state transformer is 3P. So if I am increasing the number of stages, then you can imagine the amount of loading on the first stage of transformer also gets increased. So it may causes the overheating problem and it may destroy the equipment. So to have the safer operation, the IEC has limited the number of stages for cascading connection is up to 3 only. So this is the one another approach, okay, to connect the three single testing transformers in series. The another approach, you can also create the cascading connection by using the isolating transformers having 1:1 ratio. Okay, so in a previous case you have only 3 transformers, but if suppose you are building your cascading connection by using isolating transformers, then you can see the number of transformer requirements also increases. So previously it was 3, but now it is 6. Okay, 6 inch number. So you can see the requirement of the space. Okay, if we are connecting the transformers in series by using these isolating transformers, then it needs a huge amount of space. The another thing is they need the higher number of transformers as well, so ultimately it would be very very cost effective. Second, the complexity is observed in the connections as well. Okay, so during the testing, if suppose the fault has been created, then it will be very problematic to identify where exactly the fault has been occurred. Okay, so generally this isolating transformer based cascading connections are not preferred because of the huge amount of space requirement. So in the high voltage laboratories, normally the previous configuration is more adaptive. So this is how this cascading transformers can produce the power frequency AC voltages. The another is the use of the resonant transformer. So normally the resonant transformer works on the principle of the resonance. So very simple circuit arrangement is there. Here you can have the low AC supply, This T is your step-up transformer, or you can say it as a main transformer. To obtain the resonance condition, it needs variable inductor, and this C represents the load capacitance. So you can consider this C as your insulators or the insulation of the high voltage equipment. So first, to produce the higher voltage at the load side, first you need to create the resonance condition. First you need to create the resonance condition. So in this case, as you know, that XL is equal to XC, that will represent the series resonance condition. So here the resonance condition is L1 plus L2 is equal to 1 upon omega C, where L1 represents the inductance of the transformer secondary, L2 represents the inductance of the choke coil or the variable inductor that you have utilized to create the resonance condition, and this 1 upon omega C, that will represents the reactance offered by the load capacitor. So before the application of the voltage magnitude, or before energizing the primary of this resonant transformer, first we need to create this resonance condition. Okay, so once the resonant condition has been produced, slowly increase the voltage until you obtain your required value. So this resonant transformer works on the principle of the resonance. So the output voltage that you will get is Q times V, where Q represents the quality factor. So here you can see it is 1 upon omega C into R, or in other words, it is 1 upon R under root L upon C. So the value of this quality factor normally varies from 20 to 40. So ultimately you can imagine that the output voltage would be now 20 to 40 times more than your input supply voltage. Okay, so resonant transformer is also produces the power frequency AC voltages, but it adopts the principle of the resonance condition. So before supplying, or before supplying the primary, first you have to create this resonance condition by varying the inductance to obtain this resonance condition, and afterwards slowly vary the voltage until you reach to your required level. So advantages: the power requirement in kilowatt of feed circuit are kVA by Q, because here you can have the quality factor. Okay, so the power requirement in kilowatt of feed circuit is kVA by Q, where kVA is the reactive power requirement of the load and Q is the quality factor of the variable reactors. So usually it is greater than 40. So this capacity ultimately is very small in case of the resonant transformer. The series resonant circuit suppresses the harmonics and interference to a large extent. So near the sinusoidal wave helps accurate partial discharge measurement, and is also desirable for measuring the loss angle and capacitance of insulating materials. So generally this resonant transformers, or the single unit resonant transformers, or the cascaded resonant transformers are used during the partial discharge test or the 10 delta testing, because it gives a pure sinusoidal output. So it will be better to get the accurate result for the partial discharges and the 10 delta values. No separate compensating factors are no compensating reactors are required. So this will result in lowering of its overall weight. Okay, the compensation is automatically provided by this resonance condition. The another advantage that we will get from the resonant transformer is, if suppose the flashover or breakdown takes place at the test specimen during the testing, then resonant circuit is getting detuned. So once it gets detuned, the voltage gets collapsed immediately. Okay, so this will provide a better protection against the short circuit current. Okay, as it is limited by the reactance of variable reactor. So the short circuit current gets limited by the reactance of the variable reactor. So it has been proven that the great value of weak part of isolation of the specimen may not get destroyed, and that is the transformer. So since the arc or flashover has very small energy, it is very easy to observe where exactly the flashover gets placed okay, by delaying the tripping of signal and allowing the reoccurrence of the flashover. So this is the benefit that we could get from the resonant transformer. And as the last point that I have discussed, that the arc or the flashover has very small amount of energy and it is easier to observe where exactly it happens by delaying the tripping of the supply. Okay, so it can be useful when you are performing the partial discharge test. The series or parallel connections of several unit is not at all a problem, so any number of units can be connected in series without bothering for the impedance problem, okay, which is severely associated with cascaded test transformer.